In Photoshop, we can create effects that add color to our designs and photos using various brush techniques. In this video, the focus will be on a special brush technique used to add a rain effect to a photo or design. The technique is a simple one, but depending on your creativity, you can certainly develop this technique further. First of all, we are going to make raindrops with a brush. So first, we need to create a new layer so that we can add the brush as a separate layer on this photo. Then I select the brush tool. Open the brushes panel under window, where we are going to create our own rain brush. I open brush settings. And when the brush type shape tab is open, I set the angle to 70. Because I want to make the raindrops fall slightly horizontally, not vertically. I set the roundness to 5, which is the width of the brush. You can see a preview of it here. I also set the hardness value to 50. Since the raindrops will be spaced apart, I changed the spacing to 600. You can increase the size. We can see much more clearly here in the preview. Let's make it 150 here, right now. This is the brush tip shape tab. Then I switch to shape dynamics. I lean the size jitter part all the way to the right. I set it to be 100%. Let's make the control part off, and let's set the minimum diameter to 30. I go to the scattering tab. I set the scatter value to 500%. Look, it is starting to look more and more like rain. After doing these adjustments, let's click on the plus icon and give it a name. I'll call it rain brush and click OK. And we can close this panel. With the brush tool selected, I choose a color. It can be white or light gray. This will be our rain color. Then, with the layer we just created selected, I paint the scene in this way. As you know, Photoshop has tremendous tools that allow you to express your creativity. We used one of these tools to see how to create the rain effect. You can actually use this rain brush technique for many similar effects. For example, the snow effect. By changing the brush settings, it can be used to add a snow effect to your photos or designs. For example, a flock of birds in the distance, a flock of butterflies, and so on. Of course, these variants can be increased. With this method, it is possible to add a dynamic and energetic atmosphere to your photos. Yes, in this video, I shared the method of creating a rain brush in Photoshop. I also gave examples for different effects using this rain brush method. So, where else can this feature be used? Let's share some ideas. I'm waiting for you in the comments. That's it for this video. I hope it was useful. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.